Now, we have an entirely different thing, even though it's another romantic composer, and we have a very different kind of sound, even, really. The chromaticism in Brahms and the breadth that he gets in his works from enjoying the low tones, the lowest tones. So where in Mozart and early Beethoven and even sometimes in Schubert, we use the upper tone of an octave in the bass, and in Brahms we always accentuating the lower tone of the octave so that we get this great eloquence or nobility or something that was specifically Brahms. This, I selected this piece because of all the syncopations and resolutions and all the terrific tensions and all of the originality of rhythmic effects, which if not observed, of course, the piece is completely lost. I have heard this piece played when these syncopations in the beginning of it were absolutely not observed, when it was just played. Well, I'll show you how I was taught that it should be played. And then I'll show you how I have heard it played. As though these basses were on a beat. That's the way I've heard it played. Now you can see that that isn't the piece at all. That we have to, these extraordinary syncopations are so important. And then over here, when he returns to this theme, he has a 16th note instead of straight quarter notes, eighths, a dotted eighth, and then a 16th, and 16ths in the bass, and we get this extraordinary effect. Now, of course, in order to make all these effects, we have to have the right pedaling. For instance, here. Sixteenth go from the pedal and catch the resolution of a bass that joins in. And then there are all kinds of inner voices and complexities that add to the rhythm. It's practically syncopation on top of syncopation, tension on top of tension. And while contemporary composers change the signature, the time signatures, in order to make rhythmic differences, Brahms didn't. He did it all within one time signature. And I think that we hear the rhythmic interest more than we do in the contemporary composers. Well, that's just my opinion. Of course, you can't say all contemporary composers are the same. Anyway, you hear that it's a very rich chromaticism. We want to hear all these things. There are three things going right here. In order to, the pedal has to come down after that, and off. Actually, what you're doing is taking your foot off for those rests. And then, of course, it doesn't mean that Brahms is always this way. The other pieces I've selected are very tender and very quiet and very much a different person. But even in this piece,
¶¶
Maybe I should play that piece through. Would you like to hear that piece through? Probabilities.